questa puntata vi trasmettiamo alcuni dei migliori reportage realizzati da Enjoy Television. Buona visione!
Sponsor by Rischio. Moda in anteprima.
Doesn't she look beautiful? You know, Robin, we got Italy in the house. France is in the house. I love her.
Paris is in the house. All of Europe, make noise. All of Europe, make noise.
I'm so excited because here with us there is a big icon of house music industry, Miss Robin S. Hi.
Hi, how are you? Thank
Very
you so
good.
Much.
How are you, Robin?
I'm wonderful. This is an exciting and a wonderful event. Tonight, if they ever had any doubt about any one of us on stage, they don't have any doubt anymore. Help, you know, I do. I mean, honestly, I think it does because we have icons, we have founders that are never given we have legends just like they do in the R&B world and every other world that never get any recognition for the work that they put in to pave the way for us, for a person like me. You know, I've been in the industry for a long time and I just want to be able to bring, I want to be able to encourage young people not to be afraid of this type of music because it is freedom. It's a freedom of expression. It's joyful. It makes you feel good. It takes your worries away. It doesn't depress you. It makes you love, you know? And love is universal.
Round of applause for the incredible Robin S. Legend.
Give me some bass on this mic.
Ryan, I need some bass on the mic. The cordless mic.
I would never live this down. And I thank you very much.
Because your songs are an evergreen, are always over the top, they are amazing. But why, when a song can be called evergreen?
I think it longevity speaks in volume. And I think it's a combination of the good beat, it's a combination of the words. I don't take any credit away from the writers of the song, and it also comes with a soulful singer. And in order for me to do that song, I had to literally pull that song apart, verse by verse, and figure out where it fits in my immediate life. And it came from my toes. You know, it came, and I meant every word of it, so it came from my toes.
Words are so easy to say, oh, you got to show me love.
Listen, I'm tired of getting caught up in those one night affairs.
What I really need is somebody who will always be there.
Are you going to be there for me?
Your project for this 2011.
Well, I am working on my album. I have a mixtape that, you know, has some songs on it that I've just done just to put on a mixtape. But I am working on the album, hopefully to be released in the summertime. Yeah.
So baby, 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 if you want me, you say it. You got to show me love.
Can't hear you, I can't hear you. I can't hear you.
Words are so easy to say. Oh, I.
Can you say hello to Italian friends in your style?
Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. Wait. Is it buonanotte? How you say good night?
Buonanotte.
Buonanotte. Okay. Buonanotte to all my Italian friends. I love you for life.
Cerca la moda in anteprima su rischio.it.
Rimini Disco Network, vieni a Rimini per te, soggiorno in hotel, ingresso nei parchi divertimento e nelle più famose discoteche della Riviera, Villa delle Rose, Altro Mondo, Baia Imperiale, Prince, Nuecos, Gotha, Carnaby, Peter Pan, in un esclusivo pacchetto settimanale a partire da 125 euro. Rimini Disco Network, divertimento allo stato puro. Per info 0541 451803 oppure www.riminidisconetwork.it. Amici di Enjoy Television, questa sera siamo venuti a Ponsacco, in provincia di Pisa. Alle mie spalle il dress code, oppure come tutti lo ricordano, l'ex Insomnia. Questa è l'ultima serata, si chiude i battenti definitivamente. Francesco, allora questa Insomnia, basta, è finita, si chiude i battenti.
Le cose finiscono, altre iniziano, la vita è così.
Sei triste?
No.
Sarà perché? Una serata di lacrime? No, ho sentito tutti
me,
questi discorsi.
Perché?
No, perché ho sentito tutti questi discorsi che sarà una serata tristissima.
No, io penso che comunque ci sarà tanta gente storica, ma ci sarà anche tanta gente nuova, quindi buono, una serata dove tutti si devono divertire, non è che si viene a piangere, a fare... cioè, non lo so.
Cosa rappresenta per te questo locale?
Beh, questo locale rappresenta la nascita di un casino di storie, insomma, anche la nascita di un movimento anche inverso da quello che poteva essere un monopolio della notte da parte di Riccione. Cioè qui c'è la gente dell'Adriatico che è venuta, si è spostata da lì, dal mito riccionese, e per la prima volta da altre parti è andata a ballare in Toscana in questo locale.
Dovete sapere che l'Insomnia è stato il locale nel quale io ho fatto la prima stagione invernale dopo aver fatto il debutto, la stagione estiva, 20 anni fa al Cocorico. Quindi è nel mio DNA, nel mio cuore, nel mio sangue, nel mio cervello, è dappertutto. Stasera sono felicissimo di esserci, sarà sicuramente una serata straordinaria sotto tutti i punti di vista.
Ti hanno
hanno detto che questo locale avrebbe chiuso i battenti per sempre, che questa sarebbe stata veramente l'ultima serata. Cosa hai provato?
Ho provato lo stesso dolore che ho provato per altri locali storici che hanno subito la stessa fine. Purtroppo i tempi cambiano, cambia la situazione attorno ai locali spesso, e quindi la gente mal sopporta l'invadenza acustica e anche umana che consegue all'esistenza di locali come questo. Questo è un vero peccato, perché che se ne dica, io sono sempre più convinto, a 20 anni di carriera ormai sulle spalle, che questa è cultura comunque.
Buonasera.
Buonasera a voi.
Allora, siamo tutti sulla stessa giostra stasera, ti ho sentito dire.
Tutti sulla stessa giostra, una giostra che credo capiti una volta, in questo caso ogni 20 anni, perché dal 26 settembre del 92 siamo al 30 aprile del 2011 e devo dire che si è creata una cosa pazzesca per questa chiusura definitiva. Una cosa che io non avevo mai veramente visto in anni di carriera, a livello di attesa, a livello di tutto, insomma, veramente.
Che cos'ha di speciale questo posto?
Questo posto e soprattutto questa notte racchiude in sé 4 generazioni alla fine di giovani e oggi di non più giovani alcuni, perché questo locale, l'Insomnia, devo dire che dal 92 ha veramente dato il tempo a quello che è stata la tendenza in Italia. E quindi chiudere questa parentesi in modo, secondo noi, coerente a quello che è stato, no? Noi stanotte abbiamo veramente voluto ricostruire tutto quello che era, riportarlo a 20 anni dopo, quindi con noi artisti dell'epoca, che tutt'oggi siamo attivi e lavoriamo. Quindi oggi avremo sia il fan di 17-18 anni, sia il veterano di 40.
Che vuole rivivere un attimo.
Che vuole rivivere, non a caso ci sono anche, vi do una uno scoop in anteprima, delle coppie proprio padre figlio stasera. Che hanno segnato veramente delle generazioni, a mio avviso ce ne sono 2 in Italia, una è l'Insomnia.
Che se ne va
secondo me bene, cioè partendo dal presupposto che vorrei che non se ne andasse mai, ma se proprio, come siamo costretti per motivi che non vado a dire qua, siamo costretti a farla andare via, andava fatta andare via con un evento all'altezza di quello che è stato, altrimenti sarebbe stata una strumentalizzazione sbagliata, offensiva verso la storia. Infatti lo slogan di questa notte è che l'unico dovere che noi artisti e organizzatori abbiamo verso la storia è di riscriverla, da una frase di Oscar Wilde, almeno per una notte, e questo succede stanotte il 30 aprile del 2011.
Chiudiamo così. Amici di Enjoy Television, per festeggiare la Pasqua siamo venuti al Palabama e torniamo tutti a scuola. Questo è High School Party, quarta edizione, in console direttamente dai Black Eyed Peas, DJ Motivate.
Da questo momento in console Palabama, from Black Eyed Peas, suona Motivate!
Amici di Enjoy Television, dal Palabam per la prima volta su Enjoy Motivate. Yes. Hi, how are you?
Yes, I'm fine tonight. How are you?
Good, thank you. And so, Italia, this is our country. What do you think? Because this is your, this is your,
well,
this
it's
is
like not your my first. Second. It's like my second yes. country because I came here 8 months ago with my management company. As a matter of fact, he's standing right over there, my man Fabs. Hi. But I came over here like almost 1 year ago. And it's become like my second home. So I enjoy it. Like, I love to bring people here and tell them about many experiences that, and show them like a lot of the history that your country has, yeah. A lot of the vineyards around. You know, it's a beautiful country, and it's one of my favorite. Like, it's, yeah. If I say hometown besides of America, it would be right here in Italy.
Everybody know you like the DJ of the Black Eyed Peas.
Yeah, yeah.
But so tell me something. How was started the story with the Black Eyed
yeah,
Peas?
That's where I'm not the I'm the original DJ. When and I was there when they were 15, 16 years old.
Yes.
And at that time, I knew I was working with some talented people. And I really imagined we could be big, but I had no idea that it would be as big as it is today.
Yes.
Like, but and it's really such. It's such a beautiful thing, and it's something that I created. Like, it was something I planted the seed and taught everyone and the mentor.
Mm-hmm.
And you know, it's really I really feel good about it. I'm really normal, so I don't really look like it, but I'm really blessed to have found something talented like that.
If you have to compare the situation of dance music in America and yeah. in Europe, what do you think? What can you tell us?
Well, when I listen to dance music in America, I laugh because I listen to it and I it's like, man, this is not the real dance music. Like, America, we have a good, we have an imitation. It's a different sound, but it's like, it's so funny when people of America try to produce house music besides Chicago and Detroit. Those guys, you know, Baltimore, Miami, respected, they got the sound. But when pop producers try to do house, it's kind of funny. Like Black Eyed Peas, when we start to do this music, it sounds it's the tempo, but it's not the sound though.
Yes,
you know,
yes, yes,
people like the tempo, and it keeps awake. But the sound, you know, it's cute. It's kind of funny. It's kind of like this. You know, people get it, but house music from here, like I'm doing some songs with some producers from Italy, and instead of me doing the music myself, I chose to come out here to Italy to find where the music really comes from.
The future of dance music, house music.
Oh, wow.
There are too much contamination now.
Yeah.
It's a melting pot.
Yeah, like there's so many different sounds. Like now I'm learning the difference between Dirty Dutch house music or tribal house or you know, a minimal. Like in America, everybody just thinks it's techno, you know. I think the future of where it's going, it has limits. I mean, it doesn't have limits. It's unlimited, so it can go. It's gonna go where the imagination goes.
About the summer 2011, your project?
Yeah, that's gonna be released. It's my project. It's a, well, right now we're just working song by song, but I have a song called, it's called Never Enough, Killer Tequila. Check it out.
I hate the title, yeah. And I never felt this way before. I've never felt this way about any country I've been to. I swear to tell you, I love you.
So DJ Motivate, thank you so much. See you next time on Enjoy Television.
Yeah. DJ Motivate, the original DJ of the Black Eyed Peas. Yeah.
Play boy.
Delano, la nuova spiaggia di Ibiza, Playa de Embossa.
Cerca la moda in anteprima su rischio.it.
Amici di Enjoy Television, questa sera per Winter Clubbing, quinta edizione, tocca disco. Hi, how are you?
Oh, I'm fine, good, thank you. Hi.
And so, here we are in Luxembourg. This is your first time here in this small country.
Yeah, it is. I don't know why. I think I play a lot in, it's like 40 kilometers away, German city called Trier. I play there a lot, like every year I play once, but I never went 40 kilometers over the border.
Yes. Something about the beginning of your career, your music background, where you come from, about music.
Well, I started playing when I was 10 years old. I started to play drums and I was playing a lot of bands, and then I never really found some people that wanted to do music professionally. So when it was possible to produce alone with a computer, you know, you don't need any more people, just do everything on your own. I started to learn that, and then also my father was a DJ before, also when he was younger, and had a lot of records at home and turntables. And yes, the same thing, like a DJ don't need to depend on other people, you know, you can go anywhere in the world and play alone. And yeah, so this developed, and you know, more and more and more, it's perfect for me.
Something about the nightlife in Germany.
Well, true, you know, I play now 15 years, and through all the time, you know, in the beginning, obviously for every young person it's more exciting, you know, because you see new things and you experience new things. But in general, you know, it was like a whole time when techno was really popular, you know, and then a lot of people took a lot of drugs on the festivals. And a lot of clubs were, like, in one city had 15 clubs or something like this. And after a while, the people, you know, if you have 15 clubs and you just have 1,000 people that go out, it's you know, going to be obvious that one club's going to die, or two or three or four or five. And everything shifted, but the basic thing is still there. People want to go out, they want to have fun, they want to listen to good music. And yeah, and I'm still there, so I'm just still enjoying music. I love music, and that's what I want to do for the rest of my life.
How do you see the future for dance music?
Well, I don't know, you know, I'm 36 years old now, and I'm getting, you know, it's like this, you can always calculate that one scene will last 5 years, you know. Like a normal average person goes out when he's 18 years old, and then in the middle of 20 he's thinking what I'm going to do with my life. You study, you have a good job, you have a family or whatever, you know, and then you stop going out. It's natural, you know, when you're 30 you don't go out anymore. Only maybe one time or something like this. And then for me it's now the third generation that I'm playing to. The people are 18 years old. And then obviously I have more experience of the music. I know that this sound has already been used in 50 tracks, but for them it's a very new sound, you know. So it's very, the more old you get, the more difficult it is to, you know, blend out your experiences, because you get bored if you hear always the same things, you know. So it's difficult, but on the other hand, with the new technology, it's always coming new stuff, and I'm orientating myself now in a lot of different areas. You know, we're doing the party and the label and the booking agency. I want to do different kind of things, you know, but everything has to do with music, you know. Always have music, or will always stay in my life.
The collaboration with David Guetta in 2008?
The first thing was that they took a remix that I did and they put a cappella on the song, and by that time the producer from David Guetta was Joaquin Garou, and he had the idea to put the vocals on the track. And then I went to Australia on a tour and I met David the first time, and he was like, "Oh, I love your remix from The Egg. I did a funny thing here with the vocals on." And I was like, "Oh, okay, cool, yeah, whatever, you know." By that time, the remix was already very big, you know, all underground DJs was playing it and was like a surprise success, you know. And then, he was speaking with The Egg to get the rights to use the music. I didn't get any money. The Egg let me out, although they didn't do any music from the remix. And then Citroën picked it up for the advertising. And I don't know. I think David kind of felt a little bit bad because the single was so big, successful. I think it was number 3 in England on the charts. That he said, "Oh, okay, if you can't make money with this, then maybe we make some other tracks for the album now." Yeah, and then I did 2 more tracks for the album. And now on the last album also, so.
Dove andare a ballare? La rubrica sulle serate e i locali selezionati settimanalmente da Enjoy Television. Altro Mondo Studios, il locale dove andare a ballare durante le vostre vacanze sulla riviera romagnola nell'estate 2011, vi presenta. Ogni martedì è Dance Generation, Remember con la musica anni 90 e 2000. Ogni mercoledì e domenica lo schiuma party più famoso d'Italia. Ogni venerdì la One Night di Christian Marchi. Ogni sabato Papete in tour. Altro Mondo Studios, via Flaminia 358, Rimini. Per info e prenotazioni www.altromondo.com. Tutti i mercoledì dell'estate 2011 la discoteca Amnesia di Ibiza presenta i party ufficiali della Troia. Mercoledì 17 agosto Bacanal, 24 agosto Somos Comoninos, 31 agosto Underworld, 7 settembre Templo dell'Amor. Per info www.latroiaibiza.com. Giovedì 25 agosto 2011 presso il Teatro delle Rocce a Gavorrano in provincia di Grosseto si terrà una serata benefica sotto le stelle con i migliori DJ d'Italia, Even Number One. con Claudio Coccoluto, Tommy V, Johnson Righeira, Angelino e molti molti altri. Per info, prenotazioni, tavoli e ristorante 347 41 222 00. AFC presenta sabato 27 agosto 2011 Sonica Festival seconda edizione. In console Magda, Tale of Us, Marcus Krauschar, Emanuele Inglese, Lele Sacchi, Larsen e Luca Marano e molti molti altri. Presso il Vola Open Air di Catania, per info e prenotazioni sonicafestival.com oppure atmosfereweb.com. Sabato 3 settembre 2011 Bamboo, Alter Ego e Deep Club presentano presso il Palaban di Mantova Una Notte Intera con DJ Ralph. Per info e prenotazioni www.palabam.com. Se anche voi volete promozionare la vostra serata all'interno di questa rubrica, contattateci via email all'indirizzo info@enjoytelevision.com. Destination Ibiza, nuovi pacchetti vacanza per Ibiza a partire da 235 euro per persona in appartamento più trasferimento da e per l'aeroporto, discoteca più drink nei pub e lounge bar dell'isola convenzionati. Contattaci per un preventivo gratuito, con noi potrai prenotare il tuo volo dai maggiori aeroporti italiani, programmare le escursioni, noleggiare l'auto, acquistare i biglietti per il traghetto Ibiza Formentera. Affrettati, posti limitati. Per info 0541 451803 oppure www.destinationitaly.it.
È uscita! Papete Beach Compilation volume 15! Papete! Torna il suono di Milano Marittima! Tutte le hit dell'estate 2011 in un doppio CD!
Papete!
Doppio CD, doppia energia, doppio divertimento, doppia carica! Papete!
Papete Beach Compilation, doppio CD, distribuzione Universal.
And also another collaboration, important collaboration for us with Italian DJ Benny Benassi, completely different to David Guetta. And tell me something about that.
Oh, I did a collaboration with Benny Benassi. No, I don't think so.
No?
I didn't know. I met him a lot of times. I think Benny's a very nice guy, and he's have the same thing. You know, he's also getting old. You know, he's also trying to do new things, but I think he's good with what he's doing, and he always have good ideas. And a lot of times now we play together, and like I was playing in Berlin in one party. And I was on the other party, and he's tonight, he's playing in the same club where I do my parties. So, yeah, I mean, we both get very big with the electro sound, and I don't know so many Italian DJs. On my labels, I have Ego Stereo also, they was doing, and I know a lot of good clubs in Italy. But Italy was never for me so popular, I don't know why. I would like to play there more, but
there is a strange situation for dance music.
Yes,
it's a particular period. We don't understand the future. I don't know. Okay. I can't explain what happened in Italy.
You don't understand the future from the Italian dance music?
Yes. Okay. Yes. But it's a strange period. We have to see the future, the next year, what happened.
But I know that Richie Horton, when he comes to Italy, he plays for 3,000 people, right?
Yes.
So, I mean, there must be a lot of people in Italy that like good music, so...
Yes, they like good music, but they are focused just on that three or four names, and they don't move on the other new names, or it seems they are afraid of the new things.
mean, also the problem now in these days is that you, it's very difficult for a young person because you have so much information, you have so much music, you know. Before, when I grew up, we had one record store in the whole city, and we had to wait for a song to come from England, or like a record to come from England, and then they ordered 3 copies, and only the best friend from the owner of the record shop got the copy and stuff like this. It's totally different now, you know. If I would be young now, I would be also very confused. Where do I go? What do I listen to? So much things going on, you know, and nobody really tells the person what is cool, what is not, because, you know, things like this, like a TV channel is good, so they can listen to maybe more experienced people, what is their opinion. But in general, you know, after MTV and all these channels, they don't bring anything about dance music anymore. And there was a long time that they said that dance music is dead. You know, this is like the most ridiculous thing. And then you go to Holland and they have festivals with 50,000 people and they only play electronic music, you know. So it's a big, big, big difference between what the media is saying, what, you know, what they are saying, and what is the reality. It's like that.
Also, a new project with Afrojack for the future.
Well, I asked Afrojack for a remix of my last single, Better Run, that was sung by Nadia Ali, and he did the remix, very good remix. And we met a lot of times also in Holland on festivals. We most of the time played the same festivals. And then I said, oh yeah, what do you think about making one track together? And then we tried to find time, we didn't find, and then after one festival, we were both like kind of a little bit drunk, and then we were like, let's go there. And then we went to his house, and we was drinking the whole night tequila. That was the only drink that he have. That's why the song is called Tequila Sunrise. And then we made the track until the morning, and now it's out on Beatport, and today was already on number 9 from the top 100 Beatport chart, so it's going very good, and yeah. I'm satisfied, and he's also very nice, you know. He probably come again on our party, he played already one time on our party, and he's a very good producer, he has a very good sound.
Miami Winter Music Conference, will you be there?
Yeah, it's a big drama, you know. I don't know if the people heard it already, but it's like, you know, the Winter Music Conference used to be together on the same weekend that have the Ultra Music Festival, and now they are divided because the Ultra Music Festival told a lot of DJs they can only play on the Ultra Music Festival, and the WMC people were angry about this, and now it's like 2 weeks apart. So I think that the most of the guys trying to find gigs in the middle now, that they're going for 3 weeks or stay from the 8th until the 24th or something like this. I'm not staying at the 8th, I'm not going to the Winter Music Conference because for me it's not so important. I have some people that take care of my label, they go there, they talk with the business people and stuff like this. I'm coming for the Ultra Music Festival, and then I'm playing for Robbie Rivera's party and Nikki Beach. And we're gonna do a lot of gigs around Mexico, Peru, stuff like this, and we're gonna fill the whole area there.
So thank you so much. See you next time on Enjoy Television.
Oh, grazie.
Arriva l'estate 2011 per la tua vacanza sull'isola di Ibiza. La soluzione è Ibiza Password. Ville da sogno, appartamenti per ogni esigenza.
Pararia al tempo.
Noleggio auto, moto, barche e motoscafi. Non affidarti al caso. Affidati a Ibiza Password. Da oltre 10 anni, la garanzia per le tue vacanze nell'isola di Ibiza. www.ibizapassword.com. Sponsor by Rischio, moda in anteprima.